Greetings, saints, and grace to you from God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ. I'm Pastor Billy D. Welcome to today's Moments in Ministry. Isaiah 45 and 19, it did not say to the offspring of Jacob, seek me in vain. We can gain a great deal of comfort by considering what God has not said. What he has said is full of comfort and delight. But what he has not said is scarcely less rich in consolation. It was what God had not said that preserved the kingdom of Israel in the days of Jeroboam, the son of Joash. The Lord has not said that he would blot out the name of Israel from under heaven. In our text, we have an assurance that God will answer prayer because he did not say to the offspring of Jacob, seek me in vain. Those of you who are prone to self-condemnation should remember that lest your doubts and fears say what they will, God has not cut you off from mercy. There is no need for despair. Even the voice of conscience carries little weight if it is not seconded by the voice of God. We should tremble at what God has said, but do not allow your rambling thoughts to overwhelm you with the despondency and sinful despair. Many timid persons have been vexed by the suspicion that there may be something in God's decree that shuts them out from hope. But we have here a complete rebuttal of the troublesome fear, for no true seeker can be decreed to wrath. I did not speak in secret in a land of darkness. I did not say, even in the secret of my unsearchable decree, seek me in vain. God has clearly revealed that he will hear the prayers of those who call upon him, and that declaration cannot be contradicted. He has spoken so firmly, so truthfully, so righteously that there can be no room for doubt. He does not reveal his mind in unintelligible words, but he speaks plainly and positively. Everyone who asks receives. Doubter, believe this sure truth, that prayer must and will be heard, and that never, even in the secrets of eternity, has the Lord said to any living soul, seek me in vain. Here's a slice of today's bread of heaven from Acts 2 and 17. And it shall come to pass in the last days, saith the Lord, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Let us pray. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. So until we come this way again, may God bless you and keep you, is my prayer.